In this screencast, we're going to describe what a thermal boundary layer is and how it's created. The idea of a boundary layer or a hydrodynamic layer has been introduced in fluid mechanics. So basically what you have is a flat plate, which is stationary, and then you have fluid flow that comes in, and it's at a constant velocity that we'll call u infinity. And as soon as it comes to the stationary plate, what has to happen is that the particles right here take on the velocity of the plate. They are stationary themselves. What happens is a layer builds over this plate where the velocity is changing throughout this, what we call boundary layer. So we have the same situation in heat transfer. However, thermal boundary layers are caused by a difference in temperature, not velocity, between the plate and the fluid around it. And so a good example, and we're going to look at something similar. So we have here an isothermal flat plate, and we have flow that's coming in at some u infinity. And more importantly, this flow comes in at a uniform bulk temperature that we'll call T infinity. However, let's say here TS is greater than T infinity. So as the fluid at this bulk temperature contacts the hotter plate, the fluid particles take on the temperature of the plate. What happens is they now exchange energy with the particles above them, and because of this, temperature gradients form in the fluid. So if we're looking at this in the y direction, what we have are temperature gradients dT dy. So if we compare it to fluids, we have this hydrodynamic. So let's go back to this boundary layer. And what it has is it has velocity gradients. And what this causes is shear stress. In our thermal boundary layer, what we have here are temperature gradients, and what that causes is heat transfer, which we'll call Q. Like the hydrodynamic layer, there's a point where these gradients no longer are significant, and that marks the height of the boundary layer. We call this height del, and for the thermal boundary layer, it's del sub t, and it's defined as, for the hydrodynamic, at y equals del, ru of y is equal to 99% of our bulk velocity. For our thermal boundary layer, at y equals del sub t, and now we write this as Ts minus t divided by Ts minus t infinity is equal to 0.99. From our knowledge of conductive heat transfer, we can easily find the flux at the surface, as well as define for the first time what's known as H, or the convective heat transfer coefficient. So what we're going to do is we're going to apply Fourier's law at the surface, which, if you remember from our picture, that's at y equals 0. So why can we do this? Because at the surface, there's no fluid flow. So how does the heat transfer occur? Solely by conduction. And so we write that Q at the surface here is equal, and now we're using Fourier's law, minus K. Note, it's K of the fluid, because that's where the conductive heat transfer is going through, dT dy at y equals 0. In addition, we know from an energy balance that the heat flux at the surface, using Newton's law of cooling, is equal to this convective heat transfer coefficient, Ts minus T infinity. And if we equate the two of these, what we end up with is that our convective heat transfer coefficient is equal to the thermal conductivity of the fluid, dT dy at y equals 0, divided by Ts minus T infinity. And note that there's no area term in here because we're dealing only with the heat flux. Taking a look at this, how do H and Q change as we travel down the plate? So here's our plate, and we already defined that Y is in this direction, and we want to know what happens as X increases. So if you take a look there at the expression for H, note that this denominator Ts minus T infinity stays constant since it's an isothermal plate at T sub S and our bulk temperature is T infinity. However, that del or that boundary layer, in this case thermal boundary layer, grows along the plate as the particles are exchanging energy. And therefore, what's going to happen is that the temperature gradients are getting smaller. In other words, dT dy at y equals 0 decreases as we go down the plate. And if dT dy decreases, yet our Ts minus T infinity stays constant, what you'll see is not only does H decrease as we go down the plate, the surface flux, which we have here, decreases as well. So in our next screencast, we'll look at an example where we can actually quantitatively show these trends.